Welcome back, players. I'm Jack with 36 Cancel, and I'd usually have my cat, Coco the Weiss Cat, here with me, but these decks I'm about to showcase for you are the last things that I want cat hair on. Seriously, do you know how hard it is to keep her hair off everything? But the effort I take is well worth it, because today, on a very special episode of Showcasing 100 Decks, I'll be showing you my 5 Max Rarity Weiss Schwarz Decks. Max Rarity Decks, if you're not familiar, means that if there's a shiny version or higher rarity that a card can be in Weiss Schwarz, every card in that deck is the shiny and collectible version. Over my Weiss Schwarz career, I've taken on various Max Rarity projects, collecting cards piecemeal over a period of time to Max Rarity my favorite decks and titles. This has taken a lot of time, effort, and of course cold hard cash, but the results that I'll share with you here are well worth it. So without further ado, let the showcase begin. The first deck I have here is a Max Rarity Soundless Voice deck. Now you may be thinking that it's pretty random to have a Max Rarity Project Diva deck in 2023, but 6 years ago in 2017, this was my first Weiss Schwarz deck. What does it do? Well, it has a level 1 combo that sits at 11k across turns. What else? Well, that's kind of it. Believe it or not, having 11k level 1s was actually enough to shut a lot of decks out of the game back then. Good luck getting your 6k reverse combo through this. No, this deck is definitely from a different era. From tap 2 brainstormers to level 2 changes that turn into 11k healers, to early plays that require you to have 6 or more climaxes in your waiting room, and man, the game has changed a lot since this deck was scary. But even with its age, you can't argue how good some of these foils look. This may be a level 0 bomb with a mediocre extra ability, but look at how amazing the art is on the shiny version. And have you ever seen a foiling pattern like this on an SP? I bet not for a good few years. I ground this deck for hours back in the day, and it became my mission to immortalize it with foils. And I gotta say, it's an amazing memory of what got me into Weiss. Now, I didn't just make a Max Rarity deck for Soundless Voice because I liked the deck. I also really liked Project Diva music, especially the Rin and Len stuff, like Remote Control and Proof of Life. That said, the next deck in the showcase is another one where I love how the deck plays, and I thought the source material was awesome, and that's Goblin Slayer. Look, the show is a lot more than the memes about little elf girls getting got by goblins. It's a really cool show and manga. I watched this as it aired, and when I heard it was coming to Weiss, I was super excited to try for a Max Rarity deck. And as soon as I saw the SP arts, I knew I had to have them. I mean, look at these. These are probably some of the best looking SPs in the game, IMHO. The intricate backgrounds on the SPs and SRs, and the use of the manga art and promo art on the cards seriously make this deck a visual treat. As for the deck itself, the level 1 combo is actually a lot like Belle from Danmachi, where you have a big beat-up that searches or salvages a top check 4 backup event. But unlike Danmachi, the next step in the deck's strat is to put out an early play priestess that has a Nake Soul combo. She draws 2 on play, and her combo is a pants, so it's pretty easy to recur and stall out at level 2. Then to finish the game, you have a trial deck burn package and an elf Musashi. Splashing the yellow is a bit taxing, but I think the top end would just be a bit lacking without the elf. Fun fact, I actually put this deck together pretty fast, and I was able to take it to various shop challenges in the Springfest circuit that year. I was doing pretty well, but alas, I was never able to see how it would have done in regionals, because that was the March that COVID hit. I remember sitting outside of a card shop with my buddies after winning a shop challenge with this deck, and we were having trouble finding a place to eat after the tournament because all of these shops had closed down for 2 weeks because of this new virus that was supposedly going to hit everything. You have to understand, players, that growing up, there was like at least 2 pandemic scares a year, and none of them ever turned into anything, so it was pretty jarring when everything changed. I sometimes get asked, do you remember things before COVID? And where were you when it started? Well, I was playing Weiss with this deck right here, and it's a bittersweet memory that I always think about when I look at this deck. Speaking of bittersweet, let's have a look at the next deck on the list, and my most recent Max Rarity project, Ushoku Tensei. So this was pretty unexpected. I went into the show originally because it sold itself as degenerate isekai trash. And players, I love me some degenerate isekai trash. But to be honest, I was just blown away by how much more the show was than that. I laughed, I cried, I marveled at the stunning visuals and amazing action, and let me tell you, that show has no right to make me feel the way it did. So when it was coming to Weiss, I made a deal with myself. The trial deck SP Roxy was a pretty expensive card, and I knew that if I was going to Max Rarity the deck, I'd have to pull it from my TDs, else it would be pretty impossible. And lo and behold, I was shocked and blessed to find her in the TDs I opened on the channel. And with that, my Max Rarity project from Ushoku Tensei began. I traveled to tournaments, I traded with players, I sold cards, I watched for sales, I haggled, I bargained, and I think I sold a little bit of my soul in the mix, but as you can see, it was all worth it. Look how amazing these signatures look. The SSP foiling in Mushoku is so unique. No other set looks like this. On top of that, this deck was perfect for me for the competitive circuit in 2022, because if there's one thing I love more than degenerate isekai trash, it's degenerate standby trash. This was one of the first real advantage combos printed on a 1-1 standby target, and the deck overall has some of the dumbest standby targets printed to date, like a 2-2 Gawain that sits at 9k and is a global 1k, a pole that gives all center characters plus 1500 and reflects canceled damage, and of course, the 14k burn 2 Gawain that you can't interact at all with. The deck has a lot of cards that just feel dumb and unfair to play, and I love it. So why then did I open by saying it was bittersweet? Well, this deck actually hates me. I seriously cannot tell you how many times I played this deck and just watched the most god-awful hand and stage unfold in front of me as I just cried. I play the mirror a lot, and each time I just watched my opponents open with the perfect turn 1 era standby and Rudy runner play, while I was forced to swing with my brainstormers and hit empty triggers. You can ask my playgroup, every time I would try to test the deck, it would basically give me the finger. I've watched great players pilot this deck and attempt to see where I'm going wrong, and each time I do, I just find myself saying, well damn, if I had those hands, I'd win a lot more. Nonetheless, I tried my best to tame it and took it to multiple big tournaments. I tested endlessly with it and probably put it through the most alterations and test builds of any deck I've ever played, but between the restriction coming down on the Rudy rest counter in the 2-2 Gawain and Don Matu coming out and making this deck a living hell to play, I had to move on. At the end of the day, I settled on the basic, dumb standby version without anything fancy because I truly feel that this is how the deck shines. When it does perform for me, it feels unstoppable, and even if that season left me never wanting to play it again, I'm proud to have this Max Rarity version as a symbol of how much work I put into the deck, both in gathering the shiny cards and how much I tried to hone my gameplay with it. The last two decks I showed were projects born out at least to some extent with the hope of playing them on a bigger stage, at least somewhat competitively so, but the last two I'm showing here are pure works of love, because trust me, I will never take Overlord Set 1 to any large tournament. No, this Max Rarity project was 100% driven by my love of the show, the characters, and the incredible art on these cards. Remember when I said I loved generate isekai trash? Well, I'm not going to say it again. Instead, I'll just show you some of these amazing Albedo foils. Even her SRs look incredible. For this deck, I did go with the level 1 Momon combo because honestly, it's just cool. It's not very good, but the fact that it sits at 8k on a 1-0 plusing combo is hilarious. The Ein's finisher though is super in flavor. When he kills his opponent, you get to put him back into your hand and spawn a Death Knight in his place. It's basically what Ein's does in the show, and I think it's one of the coolest flavor combos in Weiss Schwarz. Also, don't ask me how much I spent on these limited edition Albedo sleeves with their own gold foiling, but as you can see, they're 100% worth it to protect the ultimate Albedo. That's right, the pièce de résistance of my Weiss Schwarz collection, the Trial Deck SP Albedo. You have no idea how much I wanted this card when it came out. It commanded an outrageous price back then, and it demands an insane price today, so I opened Trial Decks. In fact, I opened 3 displays of Overlord Trial Decks hunting for this bitch, and you know what? I still got pretty damn lucky. It's hard to imagine me letting go of this one for anything in the world. I mean, look at her. But believe it or not, if I had to choose between this deck and the final Max Rarity deck in the showcase, I'd have to say I'd rather keep this one. My Max Rarity Gurren Lagann deck. Players, I love Studio Trigger and I adore Gurren Lagann. It's without a doubt my favorite anime of all time, and to this day I still watch clips of those big climactic moments from this absolute legend of a show. Gurren Lagann taught me never to give up, even in the face of impossible odds, and it's a lesson that I remembered to get me through some tough times and break through to the shining surface of tomorrow. Speaking of tough times though, assembling this deck was not easy. It took a better part of a year, making it my longest Max Rarity project, but look at it now. Look at the amazing signatures on this Trial Deck Yoko runner. Look at this Kaina, who does his big combo and goes to your memory just like in the show. And look at this level 3 Simon, who pierces the heavens to the tomorrows, invoking the memory of his fallen brother. On top of how in flavor those are, the combined Gurren Lagann combo in this deck that comes out at level 2 through combining Gurren and Lagann is one of my absolute favorite combos to play in the game. And speaking of early plays, yeah, how can you argue with this? I even had the sleeves to go with it. This deck has a whopping 4 Trial Deck SPs, 6 Trial Deck SRs, and an absolutely insane 13 SSPs. I won't lie, this one hurt, but you can't deny the results are breathtaking. Much like Kamina, this deck will always be in my heart, reminding me to fight on. On to the next Max Rarity project. Well, I don't have one on the table right now, admittedly, but with Overlord 2 probably coming to English, and Grisaia on the horizon, Who knows how I'll choose to torture myself and my wallet in the near future. Players, thanks so much for letting me share these amazing decks with you. Each one represents a lot of effort and dedication to my favorite titles, my favorite characters, and of course, my favorite card game. These might be my only Max Rarity decks, but I've got a lot more decks to show you, so stay tuned for the next installment of Showcasing 100 Decks from Coco and I, and I'll see you next time. And as always, thanks for watching. Peace.